Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today I'm going to be doing a complete installation video of the Renogy 50 amp DC to DC charger with MPPT. Kaylee and I have now been traveling around in our van for about 5 months, and it has been awesome. And this charger has been a key component to our solar system, has made things super easy for us. It works fantastic. In my unboxing and review video of this product, I actually went over one of the problems that a lot of people have been having online, and that's the fact that it'll only take a maximum of 25 amps from the alternator. But I'm gonna show you how you can actually get 50 amps from your alternator. Don't forget to use the code MADETOTRAVEL at checkout on Renogy, because you'll get 5% off your order. I've also taken the time and developed a complete simple solar guide that is based around this component because I love it so much. Go ahead, check out the description. It's only $14.99 and it outlines everything to do with our solar system. The guide includes a component breakdown, wiring schematic, and also a pricing quantity chart. So let's head back and check it out. All right, guys, so this is the setup I have for the controller, and I just wanted to go over all the wiring connections and fuse sizes and also wire sizes just to make it easier for you to install. I also wanted to go over how I installed it so I can get 50 amps of power from the alternator. So started off, this first one right up here is the ground connection. It comes up and around and then down, basically hooked up to the bus bar down there. The power connection is right here, and this hooks up to the positive battery and comes through a 60 amp fuse and then down to the positive bus bar down here. Both the positive and negative connections are 2-gauge wire. And then we jump over to the other side here, and I have the positive connection, which goes to the alternator, and this runs through a 60 amp fuse as well, and then all the way to my starting battery in the front, which I will show you. This guy up here is my positive solar input, and this runs up through to this shut off right here and then up to the roof to the solar panel. So this is a key part of the install. It also allows for you to reset the charger if you ever need to do that. This is my positive. The negative from the solar panel, I actually run right down to my bus bar. So you don't actually have a negative connection on the charger. You can run it right to your negative bus bar. The wire size that goes up to my solar panels, both the positive and negative, are 10 gauge, and the wire that runs to my alternator is 4 gauge. The next connection I wanted to talk about is the one on the side here, which is actually hooked up to the ignition wire for a smart alternator. But it doesn't matter if you have a smart alternator or not, you should always be connecting this guy right there. The last connection I wanted to go over is actually the RS485 port, which I have running to my BT2 battery monitor, which works really well. It also allows you, you'll notice there's a white light here, it allows you to enter a custom parameter mode for this Renogy controller, which came in really handy since I right now have a CanBat battery installed. There are different parameters than your normal Renogy lithium battery, so I wanted to enter custom ones. Right now you'll also notice that it's in float charge mode, so it's actually just topping off my starting battery right now because there's enough voltage in my solar battery, so that's really nice to have. The last connection here is the battery temperature sensor, which actually senses the temperature of the battery and will shut off the charging capabilities if it gets too cold or too hot. Mine is just sitting on top of the battery right there. It's basically just a little thermometer there. The trick to installing this battery charger is hooking up the ignition wires properly, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you that. If you hook them up wrong, when you turn on your vehicle, it won't charge very much off your alternator because the controller is designed to take 50% from solar and 50% from the alternator. So that's why it's super important to install that shutoff on your solar panels. So if you want to get that 50 amps from your alternator, you just come back here, flick that switch, and then you'll be getting 50 amps while driving, which is really nice. So I'm gonna show you exactly how to hook up that smart alternator, ignition wire, whatever you wanna call it. Again, it doesn't matter if you have a smart alternator or not, you want to hook this up because that's the only way you'll get full power from your alternator, like 45 to 50 amps. Okay, so obviously I have a Sprinter T1N and I'm just gonna take this panel off if I can underneath the driver's seat, and you'll see fuses right there. This is where I've ran my smart ignition wires to. You'll see one black and one red. So the red one runs to a fuse right here. And the important thing about this fuse, I don't even know which one it is, but you want to make sure that it's only powered when your vehicle is on. So how you do that is you get a voltmeter and you put your volt sensor right along here, and you want to make sure that it comes on when the vehicle's on. So if you go through and test your fuses, and you'll see 12 volts all the way across, and then you'll get to say this one, and then it'll show 0 volts when the vehicle is not running. That's what you want. And then you're gonna go ahead, turn your vehicle on, test the voltage at the same spot and get 14 volts. That is perfect. That's where you want to install your power wire. And then for your negative wire, that just runs, there's a ground actually located just underneath the seat, and that's where that's hooked up to. So it's really easy to do, but just make sure you install that power wire to something that has voltage only when the vehicle is running. All right, so I got my phone out here and I'm just gonna show you exactly what's going on with the app. Okay, so we're gonna head into the Renogy BT app right now. So it's not super sunny outside, but you can see we have 7.85 amps of solar coming in right now. My solar batteries are at 13.5 and my starting battery for the vehicle is at 13.1 volts. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start the vehicle and you guys will see what happens. So just start the vehicle and you can see it reads 14.3 volts. Now it has to read over, I think it's 14 volts for about 15 seconds until it'll actually start drawing power. And you'll see next to that 14.3 volts, the current symbol, that will kick in just like it just did. So now it's pulling 24 amps. 24.15 amps. And then you can see in the middle section where it says, where it's talking about my solar battery, it's splitting the current between solar and the alternator. So it's about 35 amps, like just under 35 amps basically. And that's the max that you'll get unless you install a shutoff for your solar. So I mean, this is still pretty good. Like unless you're really running low on power and you wanna really charge up your batteries, this is still fine. Like you don't usually have to go back and shut it off. This is still drawing a lot. I kinda like that it pulls some solar panel because, I don't know, it's just easier on the environment. It's renewable energy, so that's great. You don't actually have to burn fuels to get your power. So I kinda like that. I wish it pulled as much as it could from the solar panels, and then the rest would just be pulled from the alternator. Like if it was pulling 10 amps from solar, then it would pull 40 40 amps from the alternator or whatever. I wish it would just even it out so it's always pulling a max of 50. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and shut off that switch, cut off the solar panel, and you guys will see what happens. There, now we're getting 0 volts, 0 amps from solar panels, and our battery is charging at 47 amps. So, I mean, that is proof right there that this charger does work really well. You just need to install a shutoff. Now you're drawing 50 amps from your alternator. So, there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. Good luck with that installation. I hope it goes nice and smooth for you. It's a great controller. There's just that one flaw. Renogy might come out with some new programming that'll solve that issue, hopefully. Be sure to like and subscribe this video. Check out the links below if you're interested in that solar guide, and use the discount code MADETOTRAVEL if you're purchasing anything from Renogy. I'll see you in the next one.